Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Shoe Review of the Babolat SFX 3. Babolat updates the popular SFX line with a new upper design that's softer and more breathable than before, thanks to some additional mesh. Comfort is still the key storyline, as the SFX 3 features one of the most advanced layered sock insoles on the market, along with the ever-plush compressor midsole. The Michelin rubber outsole continues to be one of the more durable materials on the market. Players with wider feet who place a premium on comfort should take a serious look at the SFX 3. Now, first up on today's playtest, we have Jason. Now, Jason, I know you've tested all the previous models. How'd this update work out for you?
Really well. I was a really big fan of the original SFX because it was a little bit wider in the forefoot, and a little bit bummed out to see in the SFX 2 that it went back to more of a medium width fit. So with this 3, really happy to see that the wider fit, especially in the forefoot, has returned. Now, I think the biggest story with this shoe is the comfort. It has a very plush cushioning, and the uppers have a lot of mesh, so it's not only very breathable, but flexes really well as well. I think performance-wise, it does suffer a little bit because of that soft upper. I can feel it when I make my cuts that my foot kind of pushes against the material. But to its credit, I've never sprained my ankle in it, so that is a plus. I do feel it moving a little bit. Traction-wise, I've always enjoyed the Michelin rubber. It kind of provides a nice blend of both give and grip. But overall, I really enjoyed the wider fit in the forefoot. And I just feel like it's a very comfortable shoe.
Now, next up, we have Granville. Granville, I know you're kind of new to Babolat shoes. How did this SFX 3 work out for you?
Real interesting play test, and I was looking forward to it for that reason. I've not played with that many Babolat shoes. First thing I noticed, as soon as I got on the court, this interesting outsole pattern sounded like sandpaper, which was initially a little disconcerting, but what it applied to, what it turned into was pretty darn good traction out there. Some of the other things I liked, it's got a very solid, stable heel platform. So despite it being a mesh upper and rather thin on the cushioning up here on the front, this sturdy heel with the padding makes it very stable, and no rollover risk here for me. A little roomy up front. I was sliding around in the bit. I probably could have cinched the lower laces a little bit more, but I also enjoy that light nylon mesh. It's a very cool shoe on my foot. So overall, the more I played with it, the more I liked it. So overall, I'll give it a thumbs up.
Next up, we have Troy. Now, Troy, you've tested some Babolat shoes in the past. How did this SFX 3 work out for you?
Yeah, as some of the other playtesters are already mentioning, comfort is the big story here. Definitely a wider fit. You know, Jay's touched on that. He has a wider foot type, so definitely works out really good for him. For me, I'm kind of swimming around the forefoot area when I'm moving laterally, aggressive stop and start. I'm getting some movement inside the shoe. So a little bit of rubbing, not the most stable in that sense, but I did like the comfort for the most part. This shoe, the fit-wise, kind of reminded me of the Head Revolt Pro 2.5. But the big difference for me is that one had a little bit more padding and cushioning underneath the balls of my feet. This one was pretty minimal in the forefoot. So you had good connection to the court, you're low to the ground, but I just wish for a comfort-based shoe, there was just a little bit more forefoot cushioning for my liking. But the heel's got good cushion, the shoe flexes really well, breathes really well, but I just would like a little bit more locked-in feel, especially in the forefoot, and then just maybe a little more padding, and then just maybe a minor knock in my case. But the white cosmetic, or the white shoe that we took, the dirt got into the mesh, you know, and kind of made it a little more dirty, so I'd probably take another colorway. But overall, not a bad shoe, just a little off in the fit.
I was also on the shoe review, and the first thing I noticed when I put these shoes on was just how comfortable they are. That full mesh upper is really breathable and really soft, and I found the midsole cushioning to be pretty plush, and although it's more substantial in the rear foot, I found there to be plenty in the forefoot while wearing these. I also noticed the insole, which is really high quality. It's multi-layered. You don't see that very often, but they really invest in making a good insole, so I think you'll notice that when you put these shoes on. Unfortunately for me, this isn't the type of shoe I generally gravitate towards. Not only was the fit a little bit too wide, but I felt the stability was lacking. That full mesh upper has some TPU on it, but I don't think it does a great job for me at supporting my movement. When I was moving aggressively laterally, I felt the shoe kind of folding over a few times, and I was a little insecure about my movement. I felt like I might roll my ankle just because there was too much room in there, and it was a little too flexible for me. I continue to really enjoy the Michelin outsoles. I think that's a great addition to any Babolat shoe. It's really durable, and I really like the blend of grip and give it gives. I think that this is going to be a great shoe for somebody who isn't the most aggressive mover, but really values comfort and breathability in their shoe. And overall, it really isn't the shoe for me, but I think there's definitely a player out there who's gonna enjoy it. That wraps up today's shoe review of the Babolat SFX3. To check out this shoe or anything else tennis related, make sure to head over to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.